So here you sit in front of your monitor. You have the finest digital painting program available, Corel Painter. It's loaded and ready to go. It's just waiting for you to create your first masterpiece. If this is your first time using the program, you may not know where to go from this point. There are just so many options that are available to you. So briefly here, I'll show you maybe the best place to start is with a simple pencil drawing. There are a couple of things that you need to do before you actually start the drawing to begin, though. The first is you need to set your brush preferences. Go to Edit, Preferences, and Brush Tracking. The reason you do this is this tells Painter how to interact with the speed and pressure at which you're going to paint. So what you want to do is draw in this little box here with as much pressure and speed as you think you're normally going to draw, and then click OK. If you don't do this, you'll find that the default settings the program comes with will not work for you well with a number of the brushes. So you always want to do that at least just the first time you start up the program. After that, it'll remember you and you won't have to do it again. The second thing is to go up and create a new document. You can't draw on something if you don't have something to draw on. So here we go, brings up the dialog box. This one's currently set to a width of 1200 and a height of 1600 pixels. I think I'm gonna go with that, right like it is. I'm gonna title it, Doggy. Dog. I'm gonna change the paper color here to white. Click OK. I'm going to leave the paper texture, this default kind of plain paper texture, basic paper here, and I'll click OK. Here's my document. I like to go ahead and maximize it, so I'm working with the full surface. Holding the space key, I can move the canvas anywhere on the screen, and it works just fine. So I'm going to pick the best brush, I think, to start off with, and that will be in the pencils category here, and it is this Real 2B pencil. This pencil may be my favorite drawing tool in the whole program. Loads up, it's about 20 pixels in size. You can see it right little in the middle of my screen there. I'm gonna Control Plus to zoom in a couple times. You can see the pencil right in the middle. I'm gonna go ahead and increase this to about 40 pixels. Show you the basic stroke. I just love the way that draws. I'll do some undos to get rid of the initial strokes there. I'm going to lower the grain or the opacity a little bit down to about 30% maybe. Well, let me get it here. Go to about 30%. I like to draw with a little less pressure to begin with. A little more gray tone. I'll undo a couple times. Control Z to get back to the white. And now it's simply a matter of just jumping in and drawing the image you want to draw. So, zoom out so I can see the whole canvas. And I'm going to go ahead and begin. Like any normal drawing, with traditional tools, I would start with just blocking in my large shapes to begin with. So, great tool. If I need to rotate the canvas, I can hold down the space and the Alt key and I can rotate it around. And it just is the greatest sketch on demand tool I think anybody can have. Feels very much like traditional drawing and very easy to do. Just you would approach it the same way you do with a regular pencil and paper. So without boring listening to me talk, there you have it. If you need somewhere to start, pick the Real 2D pencil, set up your document, and away you go. So without boring you any farther, I'm going to go ahead and finish this little sketch real quick. Well, there you have it. A quick little pencil sketch using one pencil, only zooming a couple of times. Left things really at their most basic settings, so there wasn't a lot of hard things to follow. Didn't worry about going in and doing much erasing, or in fact didn't erase at all. Just wanted to show how easy it is to start up and do just the most simple little drawing to begin with in Painter. As you go, you will find that there are so many options available to you. And of course, like most artists, I can't tend to leave things alone, and so I continue to want to paint on this, but I'm going to go ahead and quit. You can see that it really isn't any more than just what it's supposed to be, which is essentially just a fun little doodle, just a little something to kind of break the ice, get you working, get you familiar with the simplest of tools, and yet, in my opinion, one of the best tools you can use to draw on a computer. There's just nothing quite as nice like it in anything else. So open the program, grab that 2D pencil, create a new document, and have some fun.